So, suppose we are now going to look for some specific type of student.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, we want to know there is a student who has done well.
Searching for,
you're saying. So we need to search through this for somebody who meets some criterion. For instance, it could be that a student has got high marks in all subjects.
What does high mean? High means?
Say above 90.
90. Okay.
So, has somebody got
more than 90 in physics, 90 in chemistry, 90 in
yes.
maths. Okay.
So, we want to look through these cards
and find out.
So, we look at the first card. So, as usual, we will go through all the cards systematically.
And you look at one by one. So, maths is not greater than 90. So, we can reject. We don't even need to look at
this. We can look. If any of them is below 90, we can skip. So, this 74, so we skip.
Okay.
62, so we skip.
Mm-hmm.
So, we keep skipping.
Mm-hmm.
Skip,
skip,
skip, skip. Now here there's a physics 90, but that doesn't help us.
Here also.
So 2, not 3. So we keep looking.
Oh.
And now we find a card.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Right. So now we just wanted to find if there's one student. So searching for one student.
So we found the student.
Oh, so we found the student. So now.
But the iterator
would say go through all the cards. Right, that's what our iterator says. While there are cards,
so you found a card, but you still be
So we have to say, because so right now, what we would say is, we found it. Maybe we will note down the name or the card number 11,
and then still go
and then we will still go through all of these searching for something which we don't need to search for anymore. Right, so that seems a little bit wasteful.
Should be a way to stop that without having to. Of course, the iterator normally would go through the cards, but in this case, we should be able to stop the iteration at this point and get out.
How do we get out? So the problem is that when we get out of this iteration, we go on to do something else.
You have to go there.
And we have to make sure that if we come out in the middle of the iteration, we are still going to the right place. So it's a little bit tricky to actually just jump away from this iteration midway. And also we will leave the cards in some kind of mess like this in two piles and all that. So, we have to be a little careful about how we do that. So, maybe we should think about how to do this.
Let's think about it. Let's try a few more examples.
Yeah,
this,
but let's see how these examples work.
Find a card.
Yeah. So, for instance, if we had the shopping bills, then we might ask for something similar. I mean, not similar, but something like this for shopping bills. So, for instance, look at this shopping bill, right? So, this is SV stores and everybody has bought food. Here, on the other hand, if you look, there are stationary, electronics, accessory. So they are all similar, but we could say that there is more than one category in this. But supposing we want to see if somebody has bought food and something else, three very different types of categories.
Mm-hmm.
Is there a bill like that?
Like say food and apparel and
apparel, maybe toiletries,
something like that.
Right? So then we would say that this is not good enough. This is also not good enough because they are all very similar things. So this is entirely food.
Here, what are you doing? You are taking the card.
We're taking the card, and then we are going down the category list
and seeing whether the category is.
Seeing how many different categories.
In this case, it's all food.
All food of different types, but all food.
All food. Yeah. So therefore, we are saying it doesn't have three categories.
Three categories that we are looking for.
We want to see whether the guy has bought three different types of things.
Three different types of things.
Okay.
So here again, we have.
Another has brought all food.
No, there's toiletries, but that's only two.
So
we want
two
three.
Items, okay.
Mm-hmm. Here there is stationery and food,
okay,
so two items.
Two items,
Here there is apparel, food.
This is three.
And toiletries. So we are done. So we have found one
first
bill.
First bill, okay.
Yeah. And now the question is, if all we needed to do was check that there was one bill like this, search
to find
one.
find the first bill, then you found it.
We have found it, but we still have this whole set of bills which we have not seen before. So again, we have to
Stop at this point. In fact, actually, found it pretty quickly.
Yeah.
So you want to stop at this point and get out of the iteration.
Yeah. So you want to unnecessarily don't need to go through all the others if that's the only goal that we had. So this is similar to the other one where we found the marks above a certain thing.
Right.
So we would like to, I think, eventually come up with a way of doing this without messing up the iteration.
Can you look at something a little more interesting, more complicated example in words? I think words finding might be a little more interesting. Right?
So let's see what we can find. So we can look for a particular. So we have these parts of speech, for instance. So we could look for, say, so every sentence must have a verb.
Should have, no?
At least one verb.
Has to have.
Has to have a verb. Otherwise, it will be incomplete in some.
Correct. The sentence has to have a verb.
Yeah. And of course, yeah, it could be a very long sentence which has some
many verbs.
Yeah, and or and all connecting. Okay. So I went to school and I saw something on the way.
But I saw. Or
yeah, yeah. So let's look for like just a first verb.
First verb.
So first verb in say a particular sentence. So we
third
can.
Third sentence, you say.
Okay, so let's look for the first verb in the third sentence. So now we have to keep track
this
of.
Has, I think this has three sentences. It has more.
Yeah, I think it has more than three.
So okay, so the third sentence we want to.
So
find
we will have
verb.
To keep track of where we are in terms of which sentence we are in.
So that is basically by the full stop, right?
Yes. So every
so
time we come
time
to a full,
see
stop,
a full stop, we will know that.
So we will have some kind of a sentence count.
So we will keep a variable keep, called sentence.
Yeah.
Count.
So we will have to keep some sentence.
Is count, you can call it. Is count and you'll start with zero.
Yeah. So initially we have seen no sentences.
So right. As we go through the cards, what do?
We will first. We want to go till the third. We want to reach S count has to cross two. We have seen two sentences. Then we will be in the
third sentence.
In the third sentence. Then we want to look for the verb.
So till S count becomes two,
we just
we are not searching.
Yeah, we are not searching. We are just looking for full stop.
Actually, we are searching. We are looking for full stop.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So we are searching for two things. First, we are searching for full stop.
Yes, up
and
to a certain
full
count.
Stop, we don't stop. See, in the earlier case, the minute we found the card, we stopped.
Yeah. So here we are looking for something repeatedly, and then when we have seen it enough times, then we switch to looking for something else.
Very interesting.
So we are doing two types
two kinds of search.
Two kinds of search.
Yeah. Like, yeah. Okay. One search. Yeah. Okay. One search within a search. Something like that.
Yeah. So, for instance, we can start here.
Let's start here.
So
it
was.
Monday. This is a full
stop. Full stop. So now we have finished one sentence.
So at this point you will.
So I said now.
Count becomes one.
Count becomes one.
It's still not.
Yeah. So now we are starting the second sentence.
So we are still not in the third sentence.
Yes.
So there's no searching yet. Not searching for a word yet.
Yeah.
So Swaminathan was reluctant to open his. Yeah. Here's a full stop. So the sentence is over.
Yeah. So now we are in the third sentence.
This is the sentence we want.
Yeah. So yeah. Now we want to look for a verb.
Now we have reached. So we are looking now for a verb, right?
Yeah.
Now for a verb. So we have reached third sentence.
Yeah.
So he.
That's a verb.
Oh, that's a verb. All right.
Okay. So we say now whatever word number.
So this is 12. So the word number 12.
Yeah.
Is the
word
first
that
verb
in
the
sentence 3.
Third sentence.
Yes.
Interesting. Now again, we want to stop.
Exactly.
You so, don't want to see. Look at the number of cards here.
Yeah. So we are 12, and we have more than 60 cards. So we have only
after
come.
After having
one.
Found what we want, what's the purpose of going through all these cards?
Yeah.
Now?
So I think we need a way to get.
We have to get out of the loop.
Yeah. Get out of the loop because in each of these cases, we found that whatever we were searching for came quite quickly, and there's absolutely no point in,
no
going,
point
through
in going through
all the rest just because we have committed to doing it. Of course, if we don't find it, we would have to go through it. But if we have found it, why should we waste the time?
But, you know, I mean, what is the way to do it? How do we get out of this iterator?
So, I think what we need to do is see what we are typically doing in this iterator. Is we
flowcharts and all, no? So,
yeah.
The flowchart, we can just kind of jump from the flow. You can go anywhere, right? You can draw an arrow from anywhere to anywhere in the flowchart, right?
You can draw an arrow from anywhere to anywhere. But if you come out of this iterator, you come out at a specific place, right? So ideally, if you come out of this,
you don't know where you come out.
Yeah, if you come out from the middle of the iterating steps, then you have to make sure that you reach the same point.
Same point where the normally the iterator would exit.
Normally, so that's a little bit.
So typically, the iterator has that condition which you are checking for exiting.
Yes.
So you have to go there.
You have to go there exactly. So you have to be a little careful about making sure that you're going there.
Going
so
there.
You have to check that the flowchart has been drawn. Somebody has not drawn the arrow going to
going
a wrong,
somewhere else.
Going to the wrong place. Or maybe we should. Somehow
not allow that. Let's not even allow
I think let I think it's better not
but
to.
I still want to exit. I still want to stop. I don't want to continue looking at the cards. But I don't want to allow jumping out from the middle.
That's true. So let's see what happens in these flow charts, right? So in these flow charts, what we do is we usually so we have this condition, right? So we have this iterator which starts with this condition. Right? Something like is there another card, for instance, right? And if so, we come down, and otherwise we
go to
sort
end.
Of stop or end or whatever. Let's just, I'll just write. Okay, so we have some situation here, and otherwise we come here, and then we come back to this place. So this is the usual.
This is the usual iterator.
Iterator,
right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And now what we are saying is
somewhere in the middle,
we want to kind of say that we are done, and we want to come here, saying don't go to the next card.
This will usually be a conditional.
So this will be some diamond, maybe. Yeah. Right. So if the card has got 90,
if it's got 19, all 90s or some whatever it is,
correct.
Three categories, something. Right. It's a verb. Then in that case, you want to straight away go and stop.
Yeah.
But now you are exiting from the middle of the loop.
Yeah. And the thing is that you have to make sure that whoever is drawing this flowchart
will always go
there and doesn't go off somewhere else. Right. So we don't want to do something like this, which would be very.
This looks messy because you have multiple arrows going all over the place.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. So the structure of this, the structure of this iteration is kind of disturbed by this, the side exits. So it's a little unclear what the actual computation is doing.
So suppose I don't want to do that. Suppose I don't want you to, I don't want to allow you to go out.
Hmm.
At the same time,
you want to not come back.
I don't want to continue doing this loop.
Hmm.
I'm not going to allow you to exit.
Okay.
But this loop itself, you don't want to continue.
Okay.
So this
thing you want to break off. You don't want to have this.
But this diamond, somehow, can I put it inside this diamond?
Well, you could check this diamond
because
at that point.
Something like that, I don't know. Because
so then you have to remember something.
You have to remember something.
And then check it at the top.
That's the way to make the exit. Same point, only the exit. Right?
Yeah. So let's see how to do that. So supposing we keep track of something. So supposing we are asking, is the card found, right? This is what we want to know. Has the card that we are looking for been found or not?
So we can keep a variable, maybe.
Yeah. So we can keep a variable, say found.
And initially we set it to not found, which means false.
Yeah. So we say that initially
it is found is false. Initialize found to false.
Found to false, right?
And then,
and now here, when we actually at this point where we are doing this condition,
if
we come out of this yes thing, then we will update found to
true,
right, and then come back to this. So we are part of the same loop, but when we find the card we are looking for the first time, we change found from false to true.
So then what happens is, and here inside this, then you have to check something.
Yeah.
It's not enough to do. Maybe
we should write it a little bit.
So found is false initially. Yeah. Now instead of just checking another card,
you have to check
another card.
If something, and it is not, we have not yet found the card.
Not yet found.
Yeah.
There is another card,
and we have
not yet found the card we want.
Yeah. So let's draw that a little more neatly now. So now what we say is that we initialize with.
This is an interesting pattern. It's a find pattern, search pattern.
Yeah.
Right. We start with found equal to.
Yeah. So false. We have found equal to false. Mm-hmm. Then we will fill in that thing later on. But at some point, we are in the middle, and we say that if it is the, say I will just say correct card. This is my question.
Okay.
Right. So this is the. So we are examining the card for whatever we are looking for, whether it's a verb in the third sentence or whether it is the person with above 90 marks. And here,
if it is
true, let's write yes here. Okay. Then we will do an extra step of setting found equal to true.
Otherwise, there's nothing to do.
Yeah. Otherwise, we just skip. So this would be what we would normally do, continuing, and if.
Oh, it's okay. So if the card is correct, in addition to doing whatever we normally have done,
we'll
also set the variable found to
true.
True.
Correct. And now this will continue, and eventually it would come back to this diamond. So this is the diamond which controls the whole iterator. Okay. So we'll come back to this point.
Okay.
And now we want to make sure that either there should be another card. There should be another card, and we should not have finished. We have not found
another card, and not found.
Yeah. So
more cards are there in the pile. So what are you checking?
Yeah.
Right. And not found. Not found?
Yeah, we can just write not found.
Not found. Found means?
Found is
found
true.
Is true.
So not found,
found will be?
True when found is false.
Okay. So which means that initially found is false.
Yeah.
So not found will be true.
Yes.
So which means that you are just checking for another card and going.
Yeah.
But when found became true,
then
at this point in time, not found will be.
Yeah.
False.
So at this point, this is still the, they may still be cards, but you might not have any desire to look at them anymore.
So found will become true. So not found will become false.
Yeah.
And because it's an AND condition, both of them have to be true. This is false.
Yeah.
So therefore you will exit.
Yeah. So this is the yes case now here. So if both are true, you will continue down, and if any of them becomes false, you will come out here and you will basically stop.
Oh, okay.
Or stop or do whatever it is that you would normally.
So basically we managed to get the exit down to the same place. Yeah,
yes.
By using this trick of.
Yeah. So this red variable. So this red structure is still the normal iteration.
Hmm.
We have just made the continuation condition little bit more precise. So we don't unnecessarily look at cards once we have finished whatever we wanted to do with the iteration.
Very nice. But you know, I mean, there is one thing that's going on here, right? Which is that this condition earlier, we are only checking whether there are cards, what is on the card, you know,
correct. Which,
what is inside the card. Now this condition is checking against something in the variables.
Yes, yes, yes.
Since condition itself was earlier the same, not changing. Condition was not changing. Now the condition is actually changing.
Yes. So we have to keep checking this
found
against the
variable.
Current value of found, which
so
is being which may have been updated,
updated.
Or may not have
so
been updated.
So it's basically the condition itself is in some sense dynamically what you are actually checking for is changing because the variable is value
yes.
is changing.
Yeah.
But only once. Once you found it's false, it's over. It's done.
Yeah.
You, okay.
Yeah, so this gives us a way to
stop stop the iteration, right?
Yeah, so when we have seen only 12 cards, we don't have to go to the 16th.
This is a pattern, I guess. This is a pattern now. It's a more interesting iterator pattern.
Yeah.
So iterator with filtering.
Yeah.
Now this is a pattern where we have iterator with find, right?
Yes.
Iterator with stopping.
Yeah, so basically when we're searching and we have found what we are searching for,
you can stop.
Then we can stop.
You can stop.
And of course the other thing is that the other way around also works, which is when I stop, I know whether I found it or not. Because if I never found it, if there was no student with more than 90 and all,
what will happen?
Then found would still be false.
Oh, I see.
Right? So, if all I want to know is whether there was somebody or not and not
so,
remember who it was.
Oh, because in this case, we always found in all our three examples.
Yes.
We found the example.
Yeah.
Suppose there was no student with greater than 390.
Yeah, then you would
90,
finish this whole thing and then
still
you would
come out with?
Then you would.
Or if there were only two sentences, let us say.
Yeah.
Huh?
Then you would be kind of unsure about why you came out, and but if you check found, you know that you never found it.
I see.
So that also gives you a way of
knowing
whether
whatever you found,
whatever you are looking for exists in that iteration or not.
Okay.